Hey y'all, welcome to the Charles Norman Show. It's Refresh Monday, y'all. Thank God I couldn't wait for today. What happened in Green Bay and in St. Louis yesterday? I'll tell you what I think about both of those games. We had a goodie in Kansas City, like I said we would. I went 8-4 in my picks for this weekend, so I'm not upset. I have some hot topics, one in which is a very hot topic, and that is the Aaliyah movie. Let's talk about that and what executive producer Wendy Williams had to say about it. Today, for our inspiration, I want to talk to you all about success. Our inspiration will be coming from Dr. Bill Cosby. Just so you all know, I had this schedule way before he became a hot topic on the show, so I'm not going to go back to my schedule and change it because what he has to say is good and we can all learn from it. So I'm going to start the show now. Here we go. Well, let's get down right to business right away. The Philadelphia Eagles are an embarrassment to me at this point in time. It looked like they didn't even try on Sunday. I said, get some pressure on Aaron Rodgers, and they gave him enough time to make a baby in the pocket. I just don't get it. I'm not upset. Those of you who know me personally would be proud. I only yelled at the TV one time yesterday. After that, I laid down on my bed and I stayed calm while I watched the Packers kick the Eagles' asses. It was an old school ass kicking. I didn't like it one bit, but I know me being mad won't change anything. I want this team to be better because the city of Philadelphia deserves it. It was a horribly coached game by Chip Kelly, both Chip Kelly and Billy Davis. They ought to be ashamed of themselves. No, I did not watch that full game, which may come to surprise to most of you. I was not going to allow myself to go through that abuse. No fan should have to watch his or her team go out there on that field and look like crap. As Gandhi once said, you must be the change you wish to see in this world. So I'm going to be the change I wish to see. I will be on that sideline as the head coach of the Philadelphia Eagles one day. And I guarantee you, they won't look this bad. Ever. Not while I'm there, because they won't embarrass me like that. Moving on to the Denver Broncos and Rams game. This game may very well be the upset of the season. The Rams defense held the almighty Denver Broncos offense to only 7 points. Thank all of you fools arguing me down when I said the Denver Broncos weren't that great. The St. Louis Rams outplayed the Denver Broncos. The quarterback who some of you idiots see as the GOAT, greatest of all time, only threw one touchdown yesterday and two interceptions. He's not better than Tom Brady, and yesterday, he showed it. The Rams defense gave Peyton Manning looks that he's never seen before, and that's surprising because he's been in the league for almost 50 million years. I'm not buying that yesterday was a fluke performance by the Rams. They came into this game as huge underdogs and left out with an even bigger victory over the defending AFC champion Denver Broncos. Peyton won't win another ring, guys. I said it once, and I said it again. He can break all the records he wants, win all the MVPs he wants, but none of that matters to me or to him unless he accomplishes that ultimate goal, which is winning Super Bowls. Notice I said Super Bowls, with S meaning plural, and not Super Bowl, because one isn't enough to be considered a GOAT. Let's just talk about the internet San Francisco-New York game for 1 second. The Giants had the ball first and goal at the 4-yard line, and they didn't score a touchdown at the end of the game. A touchdown would have most likely gave them the win in this game. Instead of running the ball at least one time, the Giants threw 3 fade routes and some weird pass play on fourth down that should not have even been called. Why didn't they run the ball? What point were the Giants trying to prove by not running the ball? That's all I want to know. Yes, the offensive coordinator caused the plays, but as much as I hate to say this, and I really do hate to say it, I'm going to have to blame Tom Coughlin for this loss. Tom is my favorite coach in the NFL. But after yesterday's loss, I think he should be relieved of his duties at the end of the season. I won't say fired, I say relieved of his duties. It kills me to say it because I love Tom Coughlin. He's an exceptional football coach. But yesterday was a nail in the coffin for him to me. Now let's get to my 3 standout stars on offense. I have Aaron Rodgers. Defense, I have Darrelle Revis. And on special teams, I have Carlos Hyde. Aaron Rodgers made the Eagles defense look like a bunch of blind senior citizens. He carved that defense up, and he was 22 for 36 with 341 yards passing and 3 touchdowns. He made it look easy. Darrelle Revis shut down any and every Colts receiver that he came across on Sunday night. He was a huge part in the Patriots holding the league's number one offense to only 20 points. Carlos Hyde had a 75-yard punt return touchdown that ultimately killed the Eagles yesterday. There was no turning back at that point. And for tonight's game, I want to pick the Steelers over the Titans. All right, time for Hot Topics. I got... I got some Ebola news for y'all. Surgeon Martin Salia has died from the Ebola virus. Salia originally tested negative for the virus over in Sierra Leone, but that was a false result because Salia tested positive for the virus in Omaha and he died. Solange Knowles, sister of Beyonce Knowles, got married this weekend. She married video director Alan Ferguson. He's 51, she's 28. This is her second marriage. Hopefully, this one works out. Last week, Bill Cosby did an NPR interview. In the interview, he asked him about the rape allegations, and Bill Cosby had nothing to say about it. I have the audio of that part of the interview right here for you guys. By the way, another woman came out and said that Cosby assaulted her back in 1969. I will have more for you all on this unfortunate story as it plays out. Okay, who watched that Aaliyah movie on Saturday night? I did. And it was horrible. I first want to say that I was never a huge fan of Aaliyah. That's not to knock her talent. I think she was very talented. But she just didn't appeal to me. The movie could have been a lot better. Aaliyah is someone who was very popular with people around my age group. And this movie pissed them off. It was complete trash. I don't think they told the story how it should have been told. I'm not familiar with her story. But I don't think the story that they portrayed was accurate at all. The casting of the movie was horrible. The girl who played Aaliyah was good for the role. But from there on out, none of the characters even came close to looking like who they were supposed to portray. The woman who played Missy Elliott did not meet the requirements to play Missy Elliott. This girl was so skinny. I'm not speaking badly about Missy Elliott, but that woman was not slim when Aaliyah was alive. Missy is slimmer now, but she wasn't slim back then. I'm a fan of Missy Elliott. I like her crazy music style. The movie was horrible. Rapper Timbaland, who was a very close friend to Aaliyah, warned us all about this movie. He said, don't watch this piece of trash. Like I said, he was a close friend to Aaliyah, and he didn't approve of this piece of trash production. Neither did Missy Elliott. One of the reasons why I watched this movie is because of one of the executive producers, Wendy Williams, said that the movie was going to be good. And Wendy lied. Well, I wanted to see what Wendy has to say about this movie on her show after all of the criticism. And Wendy said, whether you loved it or hated it, you watched it. And you made this movie the second highest rated cable movie of the year. That, to me, let me know that Wendy didn't care about making this a good movie. All she cared about was making it a success. So whether it was good or not, so she'd get her money. She knew people would watch it because it was about Aaliyah. I'm also going to defend Wendy a little bit here and put some of the blame on Aaliyah's family. Maybe if they worked with Lifetime, this movie would have been better than what it was. They couldn't use any of Aaliyah's music because the family did not approve. They wanted their daughter's life to be portrayed on the big screen. And I think it could have been a great movie if they worked with Lifetime and Wendy Williams. Lifetime makes some good movies. They really do. The Gabby Douglas story was a perfect movie on Lifetime. And even if the cast don't were perfect in this movie, they couldn't use her music. So the movie would still suck. You can't make a movie about a musician without their music in it and expect it to be good. The music is the most important part of the musician. Moving on to inspiration. It's time for inspiration, y'all. Class is now in session. Our inspiration today will be coming from Dr. Bill Cosby, as I mentioned at the beginning of the show. Bill Cosby said, in order to succeed, your desire for success must be greater than your fear of failure. I hope that hit y'all like it hit me. What do you all get from that statement? I know I got a couple of things from it, but the most important thing I got from it, which might seem crazy to y'all, is failure is okay. Some of you might ask, how did I get that out of what he said? Well, I'll tell you. How many of us want to be successful that we are so careful in everything we do because we're scared to fail? I know I was like that at one point. I was so careful in everything I did because I was afraid to fail. Me being afraid to fail was what kept me from being successful at many different things. Let's take this show, for instance. I had plans to do this show for 2 years now. Actually, my friend Chelsea and I were going to do a school talk show back while we were in high school called The Charles and Chelsea Show. But that never happened because both of us were scared that the show would fail. Looking back at it now, I wish we did do that show. That would have been a very entertaining show for people to watch. I believe that today, but I didn't back then because I believed we were going to fail. That held the both of us back. Even if that show did fail, I could have learned something from the process that could have possibly helped me with this show. Then with this show, I got the idea to do the show 2 summers ago. I didn't want to do it because I didn't feel that I would succeed at doing this show. Knowing what I know now, I wish I did do it back then 2 years ago. 2 years later, I'm looking into my stuff folder. This stuff folder right here. And I've had this folder for a long time. You can tell how beaten up it is. This stuff folder, I had this for like 3 years. And I found a paper in there that said The Charles Norman Show on it. I looked at it and I said, you know what? I'm going to do this. The difference about this time and 2 years ago is I'm not afraid to fail. Failure is a process that I embrace. I look back at the failure process to look at what I did wrong last time and see what I could do right the next time. And I've had a lot of failures with this show. One of my main failures is when I decided to put the show online. I had made a mistake of putting the show up after 7 a couple of times, and those shows don't get as many views as the show that I put up between 3 and 6 o'clock. After another failure, I relied on a teleprompter too much. By me doing that, I couldn't give you, my audience, my personality. So now, I was basically like a robot talking to you guys. Look back at the difference between show 1 and show 2. The difference is huge. Me embracing failure is helping me take these steps to make this show better. It's not where I want to be yet, but I'm not running away from failure like I did before. My weekly assignment for you all is to reflect on your failures because that will help you get closer to success. That's our show for today. I really appreciate all of you who continue to view the show. You are my favorite people in the world. Please continue to view and share this show with everyone you know. Leave me your feedback on my website, which is charlesnorman.weebly.com. Remember, our weekly assignment is to reflect on your failures because that will help you get closer to success. See you later, everybody.